this episode of Krishna and Arjun attacking Jayadrath. So they were chasing Jayadrath for an entire day, and it was closing towards the sunset, and Jayadrath was still far away. Krishna realizes no way that they can reach Jayadrath. So what Krishna did was cover the sun with his chakra, because Krishna knew Jayadrath's mindset. People like Jayadrath, as soon as their success is close by, they start jumping, you know. So as soon as the sun set, Jayadrath jumped out and Krishna removed the chakra and his head, kill him. And that's how Krishna lost his head, basically, you know. So people like Jayadrath, who are very close to success, that is the time they lose their patience. And they make the biggest mistakes of their life. So the reason they make the biggest mistakes of their life when they are very close to success is because they feel their success is due to their own greatness, their own smartness. But what they don't understand is success is never due to personal greatness. Success is simply a result of blessing of great people. So if you don't understand that your personal success is not due to your own greatness, but it is because of greatness of so many people whom you are connected with, you end up making mistakes like this. In the Mahabharata, there is a very interesting story about towards the end of the war, end of the whole battle, where the Pandavas, they are having a discussion among themselves. You know, the Kauravas are all dead. The discussion is, who is the man of the series? Is it Bhima? Is it Arjun? Some people say Arjun, some people say Bhima. They are like a mixed thing. So they decided, let us go and talk to Barbarik. So there was a guy named Barbarik. He was a demon who came before the war. Just before the Kurukshetra war started, this Barbarik was coming. And Krishna saw Barbarik coming. So Krishna went and disguised himself as a Brahmana. And he went and met this Barbarik. And he asked Barbarik, who are you? His fellow said, I am Barbarik. I have a great benediction for Lord Shiva, by which I can destroy an entire army. So Krishna said, you know, can you show me your powers? And Barbarik showed him his powers. With one arrow, so Krishna told him, so he said, he had only three arrows. So Krishna said, you know, you're going to fight with three arrows? Barbarik said, I don't need any more. These three arrows are enough for me. So Krishna showed him, asked him, can you demonstrate? He said, tell me what you want. So he showed him a people tree and he said, can you remove all the leaves of this tree and show me? So Barbarik used one arrow and marked all the leaves of the tree with one arrow. Then he shot the third arrow and the arrow removed all the leaves of the tree. And then came and stood at Krishna's feet, because Krishna had hid one leaf below his feet, just to test him. So the arrow didn't go only, it was standing there only. So Krishna removed his feet, then the arrow took that leaf and came out, you know. So Krishna was very impressed. So Krishna asked him, whose side are you going to fight on? And Barbarik gave a very diplomatic answer. He said, I'm going to fight on the weaker side. So Krishna realized this guy is a very dangerous fellow. Because right now the Pandavas are weak, so he'll find on their side. After some time, Kauravas will become weak, he'll change sides, you know. So Krishna realized this was a very dangerous guy. So Krishna, he was a Brahmana, so he told him, can you give me some charity? So he said, ask for any charity. So Krishna said, give me your head. Charity. This guy was totally bewildered. Who asked for head in charity, you know? So he realized that this has to be Krishna only. So he fell at Krishna's feet and he told the Lord, my dear Lord, please take my head, I have promised you, but please give me one benediction. So he said, the benediction I want is that I want to see the entire battle. Only my head should see the whole battle. So Krishna put his head on a stick and put the stick on top of a mountain. And that head of Barbarik saw the entire war. So after the whole war got over, the Pandavas and the winners, they went to Barbarik and they asked him, in the whole war, who was the man of the series? Arjun or Bhima? Barbarik said, referring to me, in the 18 days of war, nobody did anything. Krishna's Sudarshan Chakra was traveling around and destroying everybody. All of you are doing nothing. Can you imagine Barbarik's conclusion, you know? So Barbarik-like people, they have the ability to see the invisible X factor that governs our success. Each human being thinks that I am the reason for my success. Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita speaks about these five factors behind any activity, action that happens in this world. He says first is anudvega karam. He says the first factor is you choose the right person for the right activity. You choose the best person, you get the best results. The second is you choose the right place. You choose the best place, you get the best results. India Pakistan match happens in India, greater chance India will win. You know, if it happens in Pakistan, greater chance Pakistan will win. So place matters. If you choose the best instruments, you get the best results. And you choose the best type of endeavors, you get the best results. So these four factors are in our hands. You can choose the best person, you can choose the best instrument, you can choose the best place, you can choose the best efforts. But there's a fifth factor that Krishna speaks about that is not in our hands, that is called a daiva, the hands of God. So every action of ours, there is one factor, one fifth of our actions is not in our hands. That's called the X factor behind success. People like Barbaric, they have the ability to see the X factor behind our success. Therefore, I'll just end with this statement. Talent alone tends to make one arrogant. Talent and good attitude makes one malleable or flexible. Talent, good attitude and character makes one trustable. Talent, good attitude, character and blessings makes one capable. Talent, good attitude, character, blessings and grace makes one successful. And if you add to that the guidance of wise people, it makes you grateful eternally. Hare Krishna. Thank you very much. Any questions or comments?